salamanders. Yeah, this is not the greatest place to filter water from. And the taste is awful. Kind of tastes like you're drinking water out of somebody's muffler. But it's the best I can do for now. So, we've got water. We'll continue on. I'm not going to drink any more of this than I need to. Who knows what's in it? This has no outlet. It's just a stagnant lake. So, if you're planning on filtering water from Forest Lake and American Fork Canyon, first of all, you have to build yourself a platform out into the mud because it's really shallow. And so my filter's probably about an inch and a half off the bottom, and it's really light silt, so all of it gets sucked up into the filter unless you go really slow. Oh, getting some raindrops. Oh, that'll be nice. Good way to start the day, just a light rain shower. Ouch, this hail is starting to sting a little bit. All right, I'm gonna have to, I'm gonna have to retreat into the trees. It's getting a little painful. Okay, let's go, come on. Over here. My goodness. All right, so this is why wide brim hats are important in the wilderness. You get hail coming down, keeps it off of your head and face. There was lots of clear skies, so unless the clouds are coming in from an area that I didn't see, I don't think this storm is gonna last long. It's just gonna blow over real quick. Ragnar's not a fan of thunder, are you? Nope. Not a big fan, she says. Just one more reason you never follow forecasts when you're in the mountains. It's forecast for 0% chance of rain today. It's supposed to get up to 95 degrees. We just had a strike that was really, really close. So I'm getting in my lightning position. Heels together, squatted down as low as you can. And elbows off the knees. Unfortunately, Ragnar can't do much. Turns out the lightning position is extremely uncomfortable. Holy cow. This is the trail that I'm supposed to be going on, and it just became a river. It's been raining for about 10 minutes, and there goes the trail. Oh man, you are kidding me. Wow. All right, well, it's a narrow stream, so I should be able to hike around the edges. Two steps forward, one step back. There's a lot of slipping going on. I just heard something call out. Sounded like a monkey, kind of. It's probably a person out there. Just going, whoa, really loud. I mean, it sounded like it was on the verge of being canine, but not quite. These big thunderstorms in the mountains, which come quite frequently, have allowed me to justify my two dorkiest pieces of equipment. That is my trekking poles and my wide brim hat. My trekking poles allow me to have 4 points of contact so that when hiking through all this slippery mud, I'm a lot more stable. And my wide brim hat makes it so I can continue to hike in rain or hail without too many problems with the hail hitting my face or ears anything like that, and it has the most sun protection. Well, I was closer to the trail intersection than I thought I was. Old Trench Road number 181. Only half mile more. As you can see, my situation has not improved. It is so slippery. And I knew it was going to be harder going down, and it is. I slipped once. Mostly caught myself. So I didn't twist an ankle or anything. And I'd be better off just scooting on my butt all the way down. So slippery. I'm just having to put my poles in front of me. Oh my gosh, this is the worst. And I won't be able to use this footage because it just rocks back and forth. Well, I tried recording for you guys. So there. More concerned about my safety at this point. That was not fun coming down that trail there. I almost slipped several times. I did slip once all the way to the ground. But I avoided injury. Just took it slow. There's a reason I'm as old as I am and don't have any serious injuries to my bones or ligaments, anything like that. Hopefully, if I remain careful, I can continue hiking well into my older years. That day I had hiked all the way up to here. And in order not to miss a single step through Utah, I had to get back here from the opposite side of the mountain. I started from Cascade Scenic Drive. And after 7.3 miles and an overnight camp, I found myself deep in the woods. Far from the thoughts of anyone who could possibly rescue me. It was the fall of 2018. I was anxious to complete this leg before the snow set in for the year in the high country. We saw a bull moose. He shrugged off our presence and continued on his way downhill. He must have sensed something in the weather that we didn't. Some strange turns in the trail and unusual light patterns through the clouds made me more confused than I've ever been with directions. Knowing something was wrong, I used my compass and had to convince myself to follow it in the opposite direction my intuition told me. Soon we arrived at camp, an old-growth aspen forest on a steep hill near a natural spring. The entire area was as steep as this slope, although there was no snow as of yet, and the only suitable place I could find for Ragnar was to set up my hammock by the crook of a tree. She had only a 16-inch trunk to keep her from rolling downhill while she slept. We had no sooner set up camp when a steady pitter-patter of rain began. Thick fog filled the forest and the rain quickly turned into a raging thunderstorm. It continued for hours and the sun went down. In the moments before falling asleep, I checked Ragnar, only to find that she had slid out from beneath the canopy and a steady stream of water ran off the tarp and straight onto her poor rump. I helped her readjust and then grieved for being such a careless master. Until sleep took me. Sometime late in the night, I awoke to a much softer sound on the tarp. I pushed up on a large hanging lump in the tarp and was surprised to hear a loud slushing sound as it poured onto the ground. The rain had turned to snow. When we woke in the morning, there was 4 inches of snow on the ground. I got an early start and hiked as fast as I could. There was a large downhill towards the end, and the ground was nothing but slippery mud covered in a layer of slush. I had scarcely seen a more beautiful sight. The mists settled in the valleys. The color of the auburn leaves was scattered amongst the purest of white snow. The trip back went without incident.